Yesterday, I was clever, so I wanted to change the world. Today, I am wise, so I am changing myself. I remember posting that quote as my social media profile, and somebody commented, "Why can't you just do both, Trayshana? Why does it have to be one or the other?" I quietly moved right along, though she caught me off guard with that comment. I'm not going to tell an untruth about that, because I was all up in my feelings, and I so badly wanted to react, because what she didn't know, and it wasn't her issue, is that at the time I was experiencing deep burnout from trying to meet the demands of so many people, losing myself trying to act as 911 rescuer. But thankfully, since then, I've had some self-reflecting time, some God time, some happy time, and what I've learned about stretching myself thin, all because I didn't know how to say no very well, is this: we can't be sharing and caring hands to all when we're not even practicing sharing and caring to ourselves first, which means we can't be all things to all people when we haven't even put our all into ourselves first, positive source. And I get that sometimes we have this burning desire to save the world. At least we try to. But where we fail is saving ourselves first. We'll run from ourselves and chase everybody else, quick to snap shots of everybody else and haven't even focused that camera inwardly. But we're going to save the world. We're going to help everybody dig deep and get their issues out of their tissues when our own issues are so deeply embedded in our tissues. We just say, "Bump that. I realize I got 99 problems, but I guess my issues resting in my tissues sure ain't one of them." And don't know about y'all, but I was literally trying to drink and pour from an empty cup, wondering why the cup was empty when I put it up to my mouth. Then I had a light bulb moment, because you filled everybody's glass but yours. Oops, you forgot about the one person who needs a drink first. Now let me clarify, because by no means am I encouraging folks to stop the flow of doing the work needed for a better us until you get all of your ducks in a row, because we're always going to be a work in progress. Plus, work must continue for the good needed in our universe. I'm talking when your life is falling completely apart. I'm talking when you got pieces of yourself scattered all over the place and you ignore that you're missing your whole self and that your whole self is needed to help save the world. Instead, you ignore what's needed to be a healthy you so you can fully contribute to saving the world. And positive source, that makes no sense. What's more shattering is it's all because you don't know how to say no. All because you want to save the world first and not yourself. So positive source, saying no is okay. And if saying no is difficult, get creative with how you formulate your soft no. Here's a little tip. Simply create some boundaries, and if the ask is outside of that scope of boundaries you've created for yourself, there's your soft no. It's also okay if people take your no personal, because some folks are gonna do that. They're going to take issue with your no. Their eyes are going to be rolled all the way back to their OC muscle. Just don't let their personal issues rub off on you. Because guess what? They're going to be okay. And know why they're going to be okay? Because we've all heard no. And some of us are stronger today because we heard no. Now remember, the only way any of us will be healthier, whole, us, is when we place ourselves in first place. Be all things to yourself first, then focus on saving the world so you can fully be a healthy contributor. Now, first things first, put yourself in first place. Know that I love you guys.